wisdom. For most people in life, you think you need money. No, you don't need money. You need wisdom. That's why the Bible says wisdom is the principal thing. Why is that? Watch. Wisdom is the way God or the Lord Jesus would have handled a matter if he was on the earth. You leave the transience of man's emotion into the divine counsel and will. Amen. The secrets of God. Amen. That's why wisdom is rare and pride is so common. That even in a zeal, many times you find pride in it. Amen. Satan's kingdom is built on pride. Amen. That's why he constantly offers it in order to snare you. But the Bible says, with the lowly is wisdom. Amen. I wondered for years why, including me, God's people were broke. I didn't know that the reason was pride. I said, how could we be in a kingdom where God has everything? People quoted, the cattle on a thousand hills belong to the Lord. Then why are his children broke? He said, the Lord delights in the prosperity of his servants. Then why are his servants broke? Until I saw that scripture in Proverbs. He said, by humility and the fear of the Lord. He said, our riches. In other words, in this kingdom, your prosperity will not begin. True prosperity. Effortless. Where the glory supplies everything you need. Amen. Until you learn humility.
Amen.
There will always be struggles to tell you that you are lacking wisdom. Amen. It is an error to use material things to justify righteousness. However, lack of the material is an indication that wisdom doesn't exist.
Amen.
Are you getting the difference? Because the world has money, but they don't have wisdom. Wisdom is the counsel of God. Okay? The Bible says, the world by wisdom knew not God.
Amen.
And it pleased God that by the foolishness of preaching, that God will save those that believe. Why am I quoting it? Let me read it to you, even though I didn't plan that. But I believe it's in 1 Corinthians. Let me see if I can scroll up here and find it. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 2. Let me start there. This is something that is so critical. You have to cry out. Wisdom is not zeal. Wisdom is strategy. To learn how God does business on the earth. If you look at the anatomy of the warfare that David and the rest of them engaged in, you notice that they always sought God's counsel.
Yes. Amen.
It didn't matter how many soldiers they had. Yes. It didn't matter how many chariots they had. Amen. It didn't matter how many weapons they had. But they knew that if God does not bring his counsel, okay, you have to get what I'm telling you. It doesn't matter how much money you have. It doesn't matter what a great job you have. It doesn't matter how good things are going right now. You need the wisdom of God to maintain what God has done.
Amen.
Otherwise, Satan will snatch it from you.
Amen.
Wisdom, the Bible says, is the principal thing. Okay, let me read that thing. He just reminded me. Watch now. And I, brethren, when I came to you, I didn't come with excellency of speech, or
of wisdom,
meaning natural wisdom, declaring unto you. You notice? The testimony of God. See, that's what I'm doing. That's what Paul was doing. He said, when I came to you, I didn't come here to talk about me or anything human. I am testifying to you what God can do.
Amen.
What God will do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To convert what I claim to believe about God into practical life.
Amen.
If God can do all things, then I'll go to a closing without the money.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And expect him to deliver.
Yeah.
Watch. For I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ. Don't you see that church is no different? The way it was then, the way it was. Paul said, when I came, I don't want to know who is going with who or who is fighting with who or who is doing whatever. All I came looking for is Jesus Christ and him crucified. Watch now. And I was with you in weakness. And in fear. And in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching was not with. You see, he says that man's wisdom is enticing. It sounds good, but it has no power. Sounds good, but it's a seduction. That's the wisdom that will tell you, you don't have to take that. It's a seduction to lead you to the slaughterhouse.
Amen.
Watch now. He says, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power. Why do I want the wisdom of God? As soon as God lets me know what he wants me to do or how he wants me to handle it, immediately the Holy Spirit shows up.
Amen.
And starts dancing on what I'm doing.
Amen.
And the power of God will deliver.
Amen.
The power of God will deliver. I remember after we won the victory and the then mayor was so angry. And God told me, go and see him. That's how the wisdom of God comes. You see, through these messages, even when I return, some of you will understand who an apostle is. Because that's why I think some of you are confused. And some of the things I'm saying sound strange to you. I was showing it to my leaders. And Paul was explaining the apostolic grace. He said that God gave it for your edification. Watch. And not for your destruction. Meaning, an apostle can get you killed very quickly. Or he can also bless you.
Amen.
You take a pick. Which one do you want? That's why I always tell you, stay on the side of blessing with me. Don't go to that other side. It doesn't matter how much you pray. You're going to lose your life. It is written. I will read it to you. All right, watch. He says, and my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power. That your faith. Hallelujah. Ooh, this is so exciting for me. Watch now, you're going to get it in a minute. He said that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God.
Amen.
Oh, come on, I need to preach this for a minute, so you can understand. He said, your faith should not stand in your wisdom. Meaning, I look at something, I don't know how to handle it, but it means nothing. Because my faith is not based on what I know or what I think. My faith is based on the power of God. But Satan confuses us. That when you think about something and you can't figure it out and your so-called faith collapses, he said, but your faith is not supposed to stand on your wisdom.
Amen.
So gather up what you think as I'm preaching and put it in the trash. And come back to God's power. Hallelujah. Is God able to do all things? Yes. Okay. Let me try it again. Is God able to do all things in your life?
Amen. Hallelujah.
Whether you know how or not.
Amen. Praise God. Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Glory. I keep saying it until it registers. Your faith should not stand in your wisdom.
Amen.
Your wisdom means nothing.
Amen.
The power of God is the end of your faith. Hallelujah. You see now, Brandon came and gave his testimony. And that testimony, since mine don't seem to get it, that one should have gotten it. Should have changed all of our lives. So when you don't have the money, I said, my God, he went in there not armed with dollars, but he went in there armed with the covenants of resurrection. Hallelujah. It's all right. The first one is, they will give it to me.
Yes.
All right, he waited. Okay, that's not working. All right, what's the second one? They have to bring down the money to match the money that I have.
Amen.
The third one is, somebody will buy it and give it. Okay. So, God will not have somebody buy a ring to give to him, for him to give his intended. No. If somebody gives him the ring to give to the woman, will they marry her for him? Because his struggle in getting the ring is how grace is released to him to marry the woman. You don't understand. The pressures you are running from is what the wisdom of God has designed to give you the tools you are lacking, the grace you are missing. Is somebody understanding the mysteries? You need to understand how this works. Because many times what you're running from is what is designed to deliver you. To give you the weapons you don't have in your arsenal. Hey, and all of a sudden you see, hey, I have a grace I never had. And when the enemy challenges you, you pull out something. Hey, you feel a new weapon. When she was singing, he said, wind, you listen. There's power on my lips. You've carried enough unbelief from me. But now I have faith. If you get this one point, it will transform your life. Your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men. You don't know how that delivered me. I told you, God said to me, Satan's weapon is information, the data, how things are, how long it has been, how difficult it is. That is his weapon. He said, but your weapon is revelation. What is revelation? Satan, that's the data. But this is what thou
saith.
Oh, Lord. Hey, this is thou saith the word of the Lord. And I went to see that mayor by the wisdom of God. You see, some of these things come back to me later on. It distills in wisdom. But when they happened, it was an occurrence. I did not know that God sent me there for the guy to judge himself. And he told me even what to wear. And I had this blue shirt and bright red tie with some designs on it. And looking clean. And they finally told him he was ready to see me. And I went in there and he was angry. But I noticed that for the first few seconds, he was staring at my clothes. I said, okay. I got him on that. He kept looking at that tie. Kept looking at it. So finally, I said, you know, I came to see you. He said, yeah, that's okay. He said, you know, we are not really happy with what you did. He said, I know you're going to tell me now that God said. I said, you're right. That's what I'm about to tell you. I said, yeah, that's what they all say. He said, but I'm telling you, God told me he had given me that building. Naturally, I don't blame him for being angry. Because they had a whole vision. They even have paid for the architectural design. This Londonderry will be like Peachtree Street with buildings on each side. They were going to buy out some of these businesses and rebuild them so that you can have coffee shops and different things all up and down Londonderry. And this building was going to be knocked down and they'll build an amphitheater here for concerts and different things for the city. They had all those renderings at the city. And God preempted all of that. Amen. He had every reason naturally to be angry. Amen. And then he opened his mouth and made the mistake of his life. Do you know what he said? Don't pray for me. Don't pray for us. He said, pray for these lost Atlanta politicians. And he named a few that are having problems. So pray for them, but we don't need your prayers here. He sentenced himself to death. Amen. I said, thank you, sir. I heard what you said. And I got up and left his office and came to the altar. And I laid down here and started talking in tongues. After a few minutes, God said to me, I will give you another mayor that will work with you. The man was judged, and within minutes, the wisdom of God had replaced him. Yet he was still sin. I said, Lord, who will be the next mayor? Then this young man appeared to me. I didn't know who he was. So I went to Minister Gavin. I called him. I said, hey, God just showed me the next mayor of Union City. I said, who is this young man? I described him. He said, oh, that's a councilman that just won the election. I said, invite him for breakfast. Hallelujah. Tell him I'll meet him at the Hilton. I don't know what day it was. So that morning, I drove to the Hilton. They were already there waiting on me. Now watch. So we're eating breakfast. And in the middle of it, I put out my hand. And I said, thus saith the Lord, you are the next mayor of Union City. He hit him. He's like, whew. And then finally, after a few seconds, he collected his breath. He said, well, yes, amen. You see how the wisdom of God works? The wisdom of man will gather up people with placards and start protesting the mayor to unseat him. I went alone by God's ordination. All God needed from him was to reject me. That God said, I have given you Union City. Okay, some of you don't get it. Because that's what God did with Abraham. He said, I've given you all this. People owned the land. People were there before he came. But God said, everything is yours. God told me, I've given you Union City. And he told me that he didn't want me here. And he didn't want me to pray for him. He's speaking to the owner of the land by God's wisdom. Amen. And he got rid of himself. Before we knew it, he took ill. He resigned and left town. I need to say it again before I move on. Because I see that we are lacking wisdom. We are not able to take all the lessons I've been teaching you and interpolate them into life. Amen. So that when things happen, you go into your database and discover what covenant you need to use to handle this. The last thing you want is pride. Amen. That is feeding yourself to Satan. Amen. Am I helping anybody? Listen, let's finish this. Because I want to show you some things. That's what I'm doing. This time I am not preaching to your flesh or to thrill you. I'm delivering you.
Amen.
Watch. I know that I do that purposefully, but I'm saying when I preach promises and all this, then you get all excited. So now watch. Paul says, my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom. I've told you that a whole lot of things in this culture is antichrist. But those of you born in it can see it. Watch. I was praying one day. God said to me, look at what they are saying in America. Even my preachers are saying these things. Do you know what I'm telling people? Go where you are celebrated. Don't stay where you're tolerated. Haven't you heard it? Don't you believe it? See now. You're not going to own up. Watch. But God said to me, I said, I will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Not even where you're tolerated. He said, I will deliver you and give you a breakthrough in the presence of your haters. There's no breakthrough where everybody's singing your praise. There's a breakthrough when you're under attack. That's where God will give you your greatest miracle. America, who bewitched you? These are the lies of Satan.
Yes. Amen.
Destroying destinies.
Amen.
Listen to Jesus. You need to go back and read the Gospels. He said, when all men love you, he said, I hate you. He said, because you're a hypocrite. If everybody loves you, nobody's critical of you. Nobody's correcting you. Nobody's. He said, I hate you. So you're fake to me. Have you read your Bible? Because I don't want you walking around with empty heads, thinking that you know the Lord. But you don't know the revealed wisdom. This is where you start.
Beloved, we celebrate the wisdom of God. Why? The wisdom of this world comes to naught. Doesn't matter how smart you think you are. If the answer that you have on your heart to address or attack the mountain with, the situation with, if it is from you, even if you succeed, it will be temporary. Satan will invent something greater to bring you down. But the wisdom of God is eternal. The counsel of the Lord, that shall stand. Which wisdom do you have? Here's a clue. Go and study James 3:13 to the end. You will see clearly. The two wisdoms are contrasted. But I can tell you, if you're angry, if you are inflamed with pride, if you're thinking about revenge, all these things are earthly, sensual, devilish wisdom. But the wisdom of God is known by its meekness. You know the certainty. I haven't forgotten what happened to me. I was probably not 10 years old. And I went with these guys. In those days, there was no running water. We have to go to this place where springs flowed in this particular area. And we fetch water, and we're coming back. There was an argument between these two, I call them houseboys. And one slapped the other, while he was carrying something on his head. And he turned the other cheek, and the guy slapped him again. That was the first time I had ever seen anybody do that. It startled everybody. That guy won. I believe that if that guy is still alive, he is still reaping the benefit of that wisdom. It defeated Satan. It changed the environment. Everybody sided with the guy. I didn't have the name then that took the wrong. Glory to God. Call today, 770-994-3777. And just as I said that, the Holy Spirit said to me, there are several of you watching me. You're involved in these disputes and lawsuits. One person is an inheritance issue. So you need to let that go. It's trying to mess up the breakthrough that God has for you straight ahead. Embrace the wisdom of God for personal triumph. A triumph is a victory that Satan cannot recover from. Ooh, glory to God. Amen. It's yours. Doesn't matter where you're watching around the world. The victory, the strategy, the solution is the same. Amen. Use the number on your screen or email us. Remember the podcast, you can watch online or you can listen online, except Roku where you can see. Amen. God has brought the word of resurrection to you. Embrace it. You will win every fight. The crooked paths will be made straight. The rough places will be made plain. Your life will be filled with the glory of God. Receive in Jesus' name. Receive in Jesus' name. Receive in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And amen. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.